si registrerà la conferenza.
In order to see if someone will join. Someone more will join. Today is in many countries it's a national holiday, so I normally there will be less attendees, even though we are already almost 80, which is a super result. And I already thank you, especially the people that are on holiday today, to dedicate 1 hour of their free time to this webinar.
Was ist jetzt?
Just a few seconds more, and then we'll start. I see that attendees are increasing, so let's wait a little bit. Thank you for your patience. Stefano, my audio is okay?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Perfect. Come and press on the...
Super.
Yeah.
Okay, we are 89 in this moment.
World record.
Hello, Matteo. Good morning. How are you? Fine.
Hello. Yes, I'm fine.
Perfect.
Is it okay with you and your family?
Everything.
Yes, you know, all is perfect.
Also, everybody connected is good. It's fine.
Okay. Let's go.
Okay. So, just start. We are near the 100. It's really over expectation, considering. Considering the holiday today, but we are really successful. Welcome this fourth webinar of the series of seven about IME range, IME offer. Today we will talk about a very particular offer within our range, which is the remote monitoring, our remote monitoring solution through different web server models. This is important not just because it's let's say another chapter in our offer, but also because it's also a particular business model. So today we will also touch this kind, let's say, of topics. So how to sell it also, not just the techniques. As usual, it's me, Matteo, export manager, with Stefano, that will do the technical presentation. Also, then today it will be a particular webinar because we will also have a real demo of the software, which is very important. So you will have also this webinar recorded. You will have the possibility to also try and let's say exercise yourself on the use of the software. So there is also Paolo and Maurizio. They are ready to answer in the chat live on the left, sorry, on the right of the screen to your question. So feel free as usual to write your question in any time. Okay. Yeah. So the agenda of today. Basically, after my introduction, there will be some theoretical part by Stefano about the supervision. Then there will be the tough technical part on the web server presentation, our solution. And then there will be a demo. At the end, we will have, as usual, some minutes dedicated to question and answers. Okay, Stefano? So if we have a look to the global product range of IME, today we are talking about our software solution, our remote monitoring solution, web server, as Stefano will through web server, as Stefano will explain, it can be visualized on PC, but on any kind of smartphone or tablet. So now I leave the speech to Stefano, and we will talk later.
Okay, thanks, Matteo.
Hello. Bravo, Stefano.
Ciao, Franz. Hello and welcome to our first webinar. As already said by Matteo, I am Stefano Chiarichini, technical commercial for the export part of the IME brand. Today we will present our web server, but let's start with an introduction on the importance of monitoring and the supervision. As we already introduced in past webinars, knowing the consumption of your plants, factory or office, what is certainly the first step to improving energy efficiency. From here, we deduced how fundamental it is to monitor your consumption. Well, what are some of the points that encourage us to take the path of supervision and why it is important to measure? In some states, as in Italy, the law imposes some parameters. As seen in the energy quality webinar, for example, it is mandatory in Italy to have a power factor at least 0.95 in order to not have an additional taxation or that duty. Another point is, for example, the Industry 4.0. That is possibility of keeping under control and remotely the measuring of the instrumentation, interconnected each other and reading the data producing in agile way. Of course, even the energy performance certificate of a building is one of the points to keep in mind. Supervision, obviously, a step to be taken to improve its performance. In addition, many designers and their customers ask for a requirement for the plant. To meet this parameter, they must be kept under control of the consumption of it. We also simplify through a business model which are the stages that characterize our possible energy efficiency plan. Obviously, our basis is the energy monitoring. The next step, such as creating a culture of energy saving that ranges from simply switching off the light after a meeting, for example, or improving the conditioning, or investing in a new efficient machinery, or reducing the dependency on the utilities, perhaps through renewable energy, such as solar panel, and so on, are all steps that give different results in terms of savings. all of this depends on the budget of the customer. This pyramid therefore helps to understand strategically the possible energy efficiency plan. So, where we can measure? Surely everywhere there is a consumption, electric, gas or water. Example are campsite, arbors, common parts or residential areas as condominium. We can monitor consumption for any type of user, both single phase and three phase, and as mentioned also from gas and water meter. Furthermore, the evolution of a system also lead to a renewable and electrical panel. Here the so-called revamping or retrofit comes in our help. Well, our web server is able to connect all the instrument with the communication present on it in the IMEI catalog and collect the data produced by it. Furthermore, with the evolution of the web server, it is now possible to connect also third-party energy meter instrument. Small mention with goes to the term revamping. We intend to take a panel composed of analog instrumentation or perhaps without the possibility of remoting the measurement and transform it into a panel more, pass me the term, clean and connected. For example, the Nemo 6 series comes in our web because it's very compact and it reduces the amount of space dedicated to the measurement in order to have a cleaner panel. We will see the Nemo 6 series in the next webinar. So, from an old panel to a new and more cleaner panel. Well, as I said, supervision and monitoring are essential to reduce the cost as you become aware of your consumption. You keep this consumption under control and you can take action for a smooth deconsumption over the time. Thanks to the web server, it is therefore possible to improve this process. In fact, it will be possible to determine the annual consumption and determine its distribution on the various loads. We can analyze the evolution of this consumption over time, and if I have multiple sites, manage them remotely using a simple browser from a PC, smartphone or tablet. Well, we're using a browser, therefore, and connected the IP of the web server. So this is why it's cross-platform. So you could use either tablet or smartphone with Android or iOS system. So not only Android, not only iOS, all the devices have a browser. Well, the web server is able to read in a very intuitive way the data measured by the instrument of the Nemo, Nemo 6 range, and the new control range. All this takes place via an RS-485 connection that can be connected directly on the instrument. We will then see that there are three different web servers with as many licenses in the next slide. And also, as we say, also third-party energy meter. So, as I say, in the web server, we can divide our project by type of measured load, electrical panel, custom group, or position in the company or in the world. Furthermore, if we connected it into an internet network, it is able to generate monthly or annual reports in PDF format for a more user-friendly reading or into a CSV format for a more advanced reading and reporting. Another thing, if I connect the instrument to a Nemo 6 range, it is possible to receive the status of the alarms on your smartphone via the Telegram, is an instant messaging application like WhatsApp. And finally, if you need to have a continuous system status and the possibility to integrate the data recorded by the web server into a SCADA type software, it is available an FTP access folder in which the energy consumption of the instrumentation and the trend of the average values will be available, such as voltages, currents, power, and harmonics. Obviously for the instrumentation that already have these features on board. All these in a different CSV file. Well, via browser, it will therefore possible to view the graph and the trends for each individual measuring point. As I say, this graph will help a lot in determining the critical points of the system and plan a possible division or re-evaluation of the use of the loads. An example, let's say we have a company that work 24 hours on 24 hours, 7 days on 7 days. It will therefore be very likely that the utility generates a bill based on tariffs. For example, three different ones. The tariff will centrally have three different energy costs. So through the web server, we can determine which are the most expensive load and, if it is possible, we can move the use of load from tariff one to another tariff. So I can reduce the weight of the bill. The reading of all these happen in a simple and intuitive way through a user-friendly interface and the easy configuration that we show you later. All these make the web server a companion to keep the system under control and keep it efficient. In the segmentation of the web server range, we find the management software called Energy Management Software, the mini web server, and the most complete web server. We'd add also to the catalog an interface. It is designed to be ready out of the box with the web server. As I say, for the web server and the mini web server, I have the possibility to control the web server through a browser in a web page. The energy management software is certainly the worth mentioning. This software is able to perform the same operation of the web server, with the exception of the automatic reporting and the sending the alarm via Telegram. The software must be installed on a computer or a virtual machine with a workstation operating system, OS, which is connected to the network the RS-485 Ethernet communication interface will be installed. To these interfaces, we will connect the instrument you want to supervise. To make it work, it needs a USB license, which must remain connected to the computer. So you need a dedicated computer. Returning to the web server, we find the most complete version capable of managing up to 255 instruments. Like the software, it must be installed on the corporate network and query the RS-485 Ethernet or other web server interface. This function to query other web server is also called master slave. Later, I will be show you how it works. As mentioned, the web server function can be accessed through any browser, therefore also from smartphone, tablet, and PC. In fact, just type in the address bar of the IP addresses of the web server, you assigned to the web server. In this case, you need this the REST45 to Ethernet interfaces. Same goes for the mini web server with the licenses for up to 10 or 32 instruments. So we have two different codes. The composition of the network remain the same if the instrumentation is located in the different panels from where the web server is installed. Instead, you couldn't not use the interface if the instruments are in the same panels as the web server, because the two web servers have an RS485 port on board. Small clarification. In the slide, you find indicated that the web server manage up to 10, 42 or 245 Modbus addresses and not instrument, as I said. This will be better explained in the next webinar, because with the NemoSX system, it will be possible to put under a single Modbus address two or more instruments. Since the web server was introduced, we have been asked why on-premise solution and not in cloud. Simply answer is privacy. There are many agencies operating in the cloud, but thanks to the investigation carried out by our marketing department, it was preferred to go in this solution so the end user, the end customer, has in his end his data. Then, as I say, you can put it online and have it managed by a cloud solution. But we wanted the customer to decide on this data and its consumption. In fact, the web server recorded data on SD card for the mini web server solution and the larger hard disk for the 255 web server. In both solutions, we will not have a real data recording limit, but a compression rule will follow. In example, after 30 days, the energy data sampled every 10 or 50 minutes, we'll choose the sampling, will be compressed into 1 hour samples, and so on until you have only a monthly sampling 4 years back. So you can go back to read the data 10 years ago from now, and you have a different precision of data. Obviously, you can go on the web server every month, download the data you need, and have the same precision month by month. It is also for this reason, for the privacy, that the web server solution was chosen in plants such as the Palermo Airport in Sicily or the raffinery in Vado Ligure in Liguria. There are a measurement system made up of various instruments, including the NemoSX, has been interfaced with the RS45 Ethernet converter and the respective web server to keep consumption under control. In both the energy manager or the technical office in charge, supervise the data and creates a report which help to better understand the consumption and the possible manage it better. Another important example that help us to explain the master slave function is the Banco of Sardinia. Is a bank with over 200 web servers have been installed all around Italy into the related bank branches. All the web servers are checked from a central office, which could see the consumption for each single branch by region. In fact, with the master and slave function, it is possible to extrapolate not only the consumption of the single instrument, but also the sum of loads recorded by the web server and generate macro trends by region, by type of load, by panel or custom group, and so on and so on and so on. So before moving on the demonstration, in this slide I will leave you all the useful links for the web server, technical notes, manual, and where you can download the update. By the way, in IME we strongly believe in the web server and its potential, so that we will always keep it updated with the new firmware that expand the potential of the web server. In fact, thanks to the continuous new ideas given by the customer and the marketing office, new features will be added, such as fact the management of the tariffs inserted with the last update 3.8.4.1. Well, now let's connect to the web server that you use as demo. That it's present in our office, and you find here the IP address and the credential to access and play with the graphs and tables. So I go to the web server, to a browser. I insert the IP address that you find in this slide. You go to this page. The first page is, I'm going to log out to this page. For enter to the browser, you need a PIN code. You have a different type of user that can that have the access to the web server. There are some default password that you can find in the manual. For this type, you have to put a PIN and a PUC. This is the first page you find into your web server. It's very simple to configure it because you have only to push the button from the top one to the bottom one. Start with the web server configuration. Under web server configuration, I have different button to configure the setting of the web server, like date and time, the CSV format type, if you need the dot, the dot and comma, and so on, the network setting, so the IP address, for example, the IP address of the web server, or the Modbus setting. What is the Modbus setting? As I say, the 10 and the 32 web server, the mini web server, have an integrated RS-485 port. That's why the web server will also an interface. So if you have a third party SCADA that want also take the data directly to the instrument, you can use the web server for a first step to have a very user friendly graphs and trend, as we say later. And also another SCADA, another third-party SCADA for a more sophisticated or more complete samples or and so on. So you can configure it like an interface. After that, after the first step, you can go to add, as I say, different type of users. You have the administrator, for example, that can manage for the entire the web server. You can add the instrument, you can generate graphs and so on and so on and so on, control the device, and etc. Or, for example, if you have a guest or a simple user, you can give the permission to, for example, only generate graphs or see the real-time devices. You can also backup and restore your web server if you want to duplicate, for example, the same configuration in multiple web server. You can also backup it and restore into another web server. As I say, every more or less 3-4 months, we we put on our website a soft update that improve the feature of the web server. It's very easy to update it. You can only click to a software update, select the file and upgrade. Finish. And other things is to select what is the email list to send the report monthly or annually, select the user that receive the alarm produced by the instrument via Telegram, select how many time you want the automatic report, monthly or yearly, into a PDF format, as I say, with the user-friendly interface, or into a CSV file. I also have the possibility to have a summary report or a detailed one with a quarter hour report sample. I can also set what type of alarm I want. As I say, if I have into my system a Nemo SX, I can, that we see in the next webinar, that Nemo SX have some modules that can control or change the state of an alarm. So I can check the control, the status of this controller, if, for example, if it change the state from on to off, or it will be tripped. For example, if go over a threshold you set. Or for the entire gamma, some instrument go offline. So if I lost the communication. Return to this one. After the first configuration of the web server, I'm going to create my project. You can go under system configuration and like the other menu, I go to start to set up my web server from the top button to the bottom button. I go under to load groups and panel to generate my project by panels, by load type or a custom group. So for example, I'm in front of my panel, so I give a name to this panel. I can generate a custom name, you can put all you want, for example, webinar panel. And they say, where is this panel? This panel is in Italy. Italy or the name of your company or what you want. Save it. I create all the panel you have in multiple sites, on a single site and so on. After that, I have to select which type of load I have into my panel. I have six presets, heating, air conditioning, or water, lighting, ventilation, and wall socket. Or if you want, you can add other type of load, custom. You can add the name all you want. For example, light. I have just light, but select light, for example. LED light. Try to LED light. The same for a custom group. I can create a custom group to create a macro group. For example, I want to sum one load with another load, one panel with another panel, so on. So I can add a custom group. I create a webinar group, and the same for where is it in Italy. Save it. After that, return, I'm going to add the interfaces. I have the RS-485 to Ether interfaces, or the integrated, or better, the direct connected instrument on the RS-485 on board of the mini web server. Here I have to add my gateway. I have all around the world, all around my plants and so on. This is the onboard, the IP address of the onboard RS-485 port, or an external web server or an external interfaces. After I add my interface or the onboard, I click on devices, and on this I have to add all my load composed my panel or my line. I need only to click on add and select the family for the entire catalog. Nemo 6, Nemo D4 LE, as I say in the next webinar, Nemo 96CA, and so on, so on, so on. More important is the third party instrument. If I don't have an IMEI instrument, I have a third party instrument, a electric energy meter, I can add it, click on other devices, select the model is a generic Modbus meter. Here I have to add the Modbus address of the instrument, for example 111. I give it the name, lo chiamo third party energy meter. Select which type of fluid is, for example, as I say, LED light. And here I have to add the Modbus register of the active energy, the positive active energy, or the negative one, if you need to see the production. So you have to select which type. This is more technical because you need to know what is, if it is an old register or input register. For example, I select an old register is function free, and here the Modbus register of the instrument, for example 1000 in decibel. Here I have to select what is the decimal point, so it is in kilowatt hour. If I click on it, 0.01 is 10 watt hour, and so on. And this is the multiplier. If you have this register in you need to multiply, for example, for the current transformer ratio or the voltage transformer ratio, and so on. After that, I save this instrument. If I need to make a test, that if I receive the info from the instrument, I can also regroup the instrument into a custom group, as I say, to produce a trends, a graph, for example, webinar group. And if I need to exclude it from a totals, as after I show you the total option consumption, or excluded from the alert, for example, for the communication alerts. After that, when I finish to add all the instrument, I go back, I make the same for all the interface I have into my system. And if you need like the example of Banco of Sardinia, the bank, if you need to use the master slave, you have only to add another instrument like a type of load. After that, you have to go under to web server measure, select which type of macro category you want to add, for example, single point of measure, so the devices, a load type, a group, an electric group, a water group, or a gas group. You have only Modbus address, you put what you want, or better, the ID you find on the instrument. I take another instrument, for example. For all the instrument, you generate ID. Pay attention to this ID, because you find, when I show you the FTP access, you find this ID for the directory that you find the CSV file. So you don't find the name of the load, because as I say, you can change the name of the load when you want, but you find the ID, this ID into the directory you find into FTP access that I show you later. After that, when I finish this, I go under the bill consumption, or better, I can add the weight of the consumption, the part of the tariff, if you need the tariff, or if you want, you can make the weight for every single kilowatt hour you consume, metrical cube of water or gas. And if you want, you can add, with, as I say, with the last firmware version, you can add also the tariff. So you can generate a trend with different tariff, so with a cost rules. After that, my project is finished. I have only to show the consumption data diagram or the real-time instrument. If I go under my panel board, I can show the real-time consumption of the energy. I can show the real-time power, real-time voltages, amps, and if the instrument have on board the THD, the value of the harmonics content on this. As I say, if I install into my system a Nemo 6 instrument, I can also make a little automation. In the next webinar, we show the Nemo 6 and all the models composed the ranges. One of these, or rather two of these modules, have the control modules and the state modules. Under state and command, it show me the what is the circuit state of the control modules. The control modules, pass me term, control an interrupt, and I see if these interrupts are instead closed, open, or tripped. And remotely, if I go under generic, I can change the state of this command. As you say, you can it change the state from tripped to open or to close, open or closed. As you can see, if you click on or change the state, it change the state this one and this one. This because they are linked together. In the next webinar, I show you better, because it's not a web server feature, but it is a Nemo 6 feature. So I can link together two models to make a little automation. As I say, you can see the consumption for the electricity, but also if I have this one, if I remember well, you have also a water, okay? Also the consumption of the water, and generate graph on the water. So go to generate some graph. If I go under consumption data diagram, I can show the total consumption for the entire line. As I say, for the subdivision by type of load, and also the last one, the LED light I just added. I have this type of diagram by day, by month, or by year. I can generate a graph in this way or in pie diagram with the subdivision of load, electricity, water, or gas, if I have gas and water. Return back, I can only show the partial groups and type of load, so I can select which type of group I need to make under supervision. For example, I create some group called Hotel Cagliari. School of Cagliari, Romanian group, or this webinar group. I can go for a single type of load and show the consumption all over the time. The same for the detailed one. On the detailed one, I can click on every single instrument and show the trends over the year. This is more complete type of diagram because this is not, I don't have only this type of view, but for example, if I click on one instrument that I call the gym, I click on it, I see it in full screen. Over it, I can go back in time. For example, I go to, I have the subdivision by year, the 2020 year. If you want, you can click on the month you want to see the trend, for example, April. On the April, if you want, you can go on a certain date, for example, the 18th of April. And here I can you can show me the consumption hour by hour. So I can go to explode my diagram and go from year by year to month by month, from month to day, today by hour. All this data, as I say, you have in this type of diagram, or into CSV file or into a PDF file. So the web server generate this type of reports in two different ways, or better, three different ways, via browser, via PDF file, or CSV file. Another important things is to compare. If I click on compare, it show me this type of, if I click on compare, it show me what is the consumption of two different instruments or two different sites. For take an example for the multi-site, like the Bank of Sardinia, I can take the one of the less resource less energy consumed branch and compare it with all the branches. This is important because I can make a target to say if this branch consume this type of energy, less energy, why the other branch consume a lot than this? As we say in the pyramid, I can take some points to reduce this consumption. For example, switch off the light after meeting, switch off the air conditioning at the end of the work, at the end of the day, and so on. So I can compare day by day, month by month, year by year, the consumption of I can compare the consumption of two different devices, two different load, two different panel, two different branches, two different what you want. Finish or better. For this part, for the part of the via browser, I have finished. For the part reports and data download, I can go to download into CSV file or PDF file, as I say, automatically via a monthly or annually auto-send report, or manually. I can go into the web server, go into reports and data download, go to data download, select which instrument I need the reports, for example, I select all. From one to one, for example, 2019, month 10, October, 1 October to today is 2020, 05, today is 21. I can create a file with the cost file if I add a tariff, And what is the sample I need? Minutes, hour, days, or month. Click on download. It's generating a file. And download it. Okay, he downloaded a zip file. On it, he generate three different report because, as I say, I don't mix together electricity, gas, water. I have three different report. I go under the electricity because for this demo is one of the most completed. Or better, I have to open it because it is a CSV file. I copy into the load. Okay. I open it in this file. I go under data from a CSV file. Very speed computer, sorry. Okay, click on the load and click on report devices. Here I can show the rule, as I say, for the CSV file. So you have to select if I have dot or dot and comma type of subdivision and so on. And go to charge and charge my file. As you just see in this preview, I have the subdivision by type of load, by type of the name of the instrument, and so on and so on. So I have create a consumption with the rule as I found it. So I don't have the consumption every 50 minutes because it's over the 30 days that I show. If I go nearest today, he show me, as I say, is a demo, so I don't have all the data. He show me the consumption every 50 minutes. So every 50 minutes, I have the consumption during the day. Probably it don't open the CSV file in the right way. So in this, or better, or don't have the right consumption. In this way, I give you the every 50 minutes, what is the consumption reported by the instrument. I can make the same for a PDF file. I return it, I go to cancel, F1, yes, for reports. Under reports, I can create, this is a more user-friendly interfaces, because under this, I can create a monthly report, the report one, I download it, perfect, into a PDF file. You open a PDF file like this. When you open, my computer is very speed today. Okay, with an overall consumption, if I have electricity, or this is because of the month of January, if I have electricity and so on, and what is the consumption of gas, water, and electricity. This is the monthly report with the not detailed one. You have two files, the detailed one and not detailed one. This is a general consumption with that compared this month with the last month. What is the my if I have more green than the other month, what is the general trend for all the electricity load I have into my plan, and what is the consumption day by day, divided by type of load, by type of panel, and so on, so on, so on. I have the same for the detailed one. So I have the subdivision for every single type of load. So you don't have the more macro areas, but I have the single devices with the name that I put on the web server. Grettle the light, Grettle socket, and so on, so on, so on. I have one instrument that I have a complete diagram, as I say, gyms and rooms. Okay, all these type of PDF file is just the same you receive by email if you select the automatic report feature. The last and not the least, the report of the alarm. As I say, if you have the NEMO 6 into your range, you have also different type of alarm generated by the instrument. The last one, because I think we have finished the time, is the FTP access. You need only to click or better to copy the IP address of your web server with the prefix of the FTP, not the HTTP, but the FTP, and you go under the FTP directory. As I say, it's subdivided by type of devices, by type of report you want, type of load, and so on. Under devices, as I say, you find the number, the ID number that the web server give to every single instrument. Under this instrument, under every single instrument, you have free or far file, depend of the instrument you have. If I go under system configuration, gateway, devices, sorry, this one, and devices, I selected the GIM one, it is the ID 26 here, you have three or four file, depend which instrument you have, because as I say, not all the instrument have the real-time values, depend of type of instrument you have. You have the consumption of the energy of the actual MAFT, you have the stats with the average values of current voltage and so on, and the THD, so the harmonics content. All this file, as I say, you can copy or share this directory and put it into a cloud like OneDrive, Google Drive, or you want, so you can have all this data into a cloud service or an external agency as you want. So I think it's finished. We have 2 minutes. Matteo?
Yes, Stefano. Unfortunately, the time is not a lot. I think we will take also some more minutes after 12 o'clock. Can you please show the slide?
Yes.
Okay, so what I'm the message I'm giving to you here is it's not at all a technical one, but I think it's very important for the success of the business related to this solution. Why this? Because Stefano has shown in detail the technique on how to use the software, how to configure it, etc., the different models of the web server. But it will be useless if you don't approach the right person. The right person is the one that has the need to save the energy. First, to understand how much he is consuming. Secondly, to save energy. And many times he needs to save money, or he has some obligation due to legislation or due to local standards, which are in some cases turned to legislation. So this person is the investor. Who influences the investor? The investor is influenced by different actors in the world of energy efficiency. These actors, in detail, can be technical consultants working on green projects, energy service companies. These are companies that are also able to finance a project in what sense they will give the capital to the investor, like this, and they will be paid by the investor with the saving in the energy bill. So this is a win-win business model. The facility manager, who is an external company normally that manages all the maintenance of a building. The energy manager, normally he is internal in the organization. For instance, the bank, a bank group, has an energy manager normally. So this is the person that has to be approached because he's the person that will use the software. A system integrator. A system integrator is an expert in integration of systems. One of his tasks, for sure, will be to put in place an integrated system to save the energy. So all these people have to understand our remote monitoring solution, and they will explain, because they have the contact with the investor. Once you have convinced these people, the project will have a high probability to be in your hands. Okay, Stefano? So my message here is, don't focus when you want to sell a web server or our remote monitoring system, don't focus on panel builders or just on panel builders or on electrician or electrical distributors, because they have no influence on the investor. You need to focus on prescriptors, and in particular, the prescriptors that work on energy efficiency projects, which are, I repeat, energy service companies, energy managers, facility managers, sustainability consultants, and system integrators. I know it's not easy, but it has to be done. You have to build absolutely a network. And we are available to help you on this, but you have to build a network of this kind of targets. Okay, Stefan. So question and answer. I will try to read quickly, Stefano, because it's we have few time and it's a question really. The first one, a recurrent one, is temperature monitoring possible?
No, because we don't have in our range an instrument that collect the data from the temperature. I can only show, for example, with the NEMO SX modules on the back, NEMO modules a temperature, but I can't show the graph of the temperature.
Okay. So, second question. Can web server collect the data from an electrical vehicle charging station, both Legrand or a third party?
Yes, you can. As I say, you into the web server you can add the entire catalog of the email catalog, or also the Legrand or BTC no catalog. But you can also, if you don't find it into the list, you can also add a third party instrument, so you can only to know what is the registry map, the Modbus registry map on it, and add the register of the active energy.
Okay. Okay, from Michele, sorry, I forgot to say the names of the people. So the first one was Stephanie, and Andrei the second. Michalis. Can web server be considered equivalent to MIDAS? Can it monitor multimeter measurements like voltage, ampere? If not, is there a development plan for this?
Yes, for all the two questions, or better. Yes, it's the substitution of the MIDAS 7. For the moment, you have only the average values of the current voltage and so on. The parts of the energy is the same. The type of diagram is the same. On the web server, as I can show in the FTP access, you have the average values of current voltage and so on. As I know, in the future there will be another update that expand the possibility to total substitute the media servo in all these features. For example, the last one, we add also the tariff.
From Hugo, solution for more than 255 points of measure?
The master slave solution. So you can you use multiple 245 instrument on it and a master instrument that can manage the other instrument.
Stephanie, can I swap or change the USB to another computer and still use it? The USB.
USB license, I think. Yeah, yes, but the license must be connected to the computer if you want to reach the instrument. So the license permit you to retrieve the data from the instrument. If you don't have the web server, the license, you can retrieve this information. So it stop to logging from one PC to another PC. So only the PC have the USB license can record the data.
From Marco, the master slave system is only possible with the web server or also with other softwares that we have in our range?
What do you mean? Use, for example, the software to collect the data of the web server. Yes, but it's not created for this type of solution. It's created for for example, little web server, the mini web server installed all around the world, all around the company, and the central, for example, web server to control every single point of measure or every single web server. This is the idea of the master slave.
From Josué, if several web servers are in different locations, how can we group all the information?
I have to put a static IP for every single web server, and if I know this static IP or the public IP or the VPN IP that I give to this web server, I retrieve the data via browser to this web server.
From Mizuko, maybe Beat, is it possible to update existing web server on version 3.8?
Yes, surely. In the next week, we add the last version to our website. You can only download it and click update on the web server and finish.
Ruben, this was a little bit complicated. If I have a network, I think an IP network around all the country, can we connect one RS-485 Ethernet converter with local IP and connect just one web server in one point of the network and communicate all the measures in the internal network?
Yes, surely. If the web server can pass me the term, view the IP address of the interface, you can put the web server all around your network and the interface in another parts. You must only that web server can view the interface and speak with this interface. So yes.
Marco, future plans to include the tariff analysis in the web server, for examples, consumptions in different periods during the day directly in the web server.
Yes, with the last firmware update, I don't know if Marco just received it, the 3.1.1, 3.8.1, you have also the tariff one. So you can compare the tariff.
Hugo wanted you to show the third party configuration. You did it during the demo.
Okay.
Okay, there was a question about where we store the videos and the webinar registration. It has been answered in the chat. Marco is asking, what is the last version of the firmware?
3.8.1. On the website you find 3.7.0. 3.8.1 is a beta version, but is also the final version that you find, as I say, in the next weeks, more or less.
From Fekra, maximum number of users that can be added.
I think there isn't a limit. I don't know the project, but the last time I had 10 different users and he can manage it, but I have to check it. I think there isn't a limit.
From Dimitar, the new energy meters, the new range, can I see it with the web server?
Yes, surely. With the last firmware version, as I say, 3.1.1, we had also the last new energy meter range.
Marco wanted to know if I can edit information in PDF. You show this. Hugo, can I manage energy of electrical vehicle charging station? You already answered before. From Mezuko, is the remote access possible? Yes, it is.
Yes.
Okay, Dimitar has some issue in his office to connect the web server with the new energy meter. Probably is the firmware. Can it be a firmware update too?
Yes, probably, because he don't find the new conto range. Probably he added the old conto. If you add the old conto and you don't change, as I said in the last webinar, if you don't change the protocol from basic to standard, you can't reach the information. It is better to update to the last version.
From Marco, can I know through the web server the maximum demand in kilowatt of each equipment in a month?
Yes, you can. This is one of the trends you can generate with the web server.
Okay. But I did not get very much this question. I tried to tell it to you. No, from Pablo, non-replaceable button battery which feed the RTCL is empty. Why it cannot be replaced?
Oh, I think he said that there, in internal of the web server, there is a real-time clock that this real-time clock is needed to take the clock updated, and the possibility is that or to keep the web server always on, or if you the battery on it discharge, you lost the clock and you have to re-enter the time. But as you know, for the project, out of the power supply, if you don't power supply the web server, the battery on it during 5 to 7 years, more or less. So if you have a web server into your storage, you need to power supply after 5 years. But 5 years isn't enough.
From Theodoros, does it recognize email grand meters when connected, or do they have to be registered manually?
You have to select it, the IME alternative instrument, or add it as a third party instrument.
From Husam, also on this, I'm not sure to have understood. Is a system that we can use for MDV?
I don't know what is MDV.
Me too. Husam, if you want to write in the chat to specify what you mean, thank you. And the other one is, can we integrate with EGBT switching?
I don't know what is this type of switching, but as I say, is EGBT switching? I think is in hub is an hub. I don't know. Probably because you think there are some problem of IP addresses or Ethernet cables on. No? I don't know.
Well, maybe we will treat with USAN directly with emails. From Dimitar, tariff visualization of energy.
Yes, with the last firm.
Pablo wanted to see an example of Telegram alarm.
An example of Telegram alarm? I don't have it, but I don't have it. I don't know. But it's only a simple alarm you find if you know what is Telegram. He receive a Telegram messages with these events: time, what is the name and device, what is the addresses, and what is the error.
From also Husam, this was probably a question, but not related to this device, about harmonic mitigation techniques. But we will talk with Husam privately. From Josue, what is the module for automation?
I think you speak about the NEMO 6. Is exactly. The control modules and the state modules. We see in the next webinar.
Okay. Marco, does the web server take actions automatically based on a measurement? For example, I fix a threshold, and when I pass the threshold, the breaker trips.
It's not a web server feature. It's a NEMO 6 feature that we show in the next webinar.
Okay. Is web server, Mohammed, is web server using static IP address?
Yes, or the HTTP. You can choose one or the other. Under these, under web server configuration, XSER. No, they remove it. Sorry, only static IP address.
Rajesh, the system of supervision by metering is wired to connect to computer. Is there a wireless connection between meters and computer? If so, how and under which frequency can it be connected?
In our range, we sell a radio solution that is an RS-45 radio solution. So it converted the RS-45 line to a radio 868 megahertz. It go to another points that it convert from radio to RS-45. These RS-45 go to the web server.
Girish, could you update us on the configuration of web server for more than 500 devices?
Sorry, can you repeat, because it stopped.
If you have more than 500 devices.
More than 500, you have to use two web server and or better. You can go to this, to have two solution. For you have a single central part to show all the consumption, you need the free web server. Two web server with the 255 web server that manage the single point of measure, and a master web server that can log, that can take the data from the two slave web server and manage the entire system into one IP address, into one browser.
From Girish, are the web server servers IFTTT compatible?
Sorry?
Are the web server IFTTT compatible?
Yes. I showed the FTP access through the FTP. You have only to put the FTP and the IP address of the web server and go into the FTP addresses.
From Mohammed, is firmware upgrade free?
Yes, surely.
Okay, we have finished the questions.
Perfect. So, have a nice day.
Wait, put the slide, the last slide.
Sorry, you're right.
Okay, so we see you, everybody, in 1 week, same day, same time. And we will talk about Nemo SX. So as you could see, Nemo SX is really related to also the web server. So don't miss our next webinar next Thursday. Thanks a lot. We really appreciate that you have been here all this time during, for many of you, a holiday, a vacation day. Thanks again. We really appreciate.
Have a nice day.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye. Ciao.